Creating layouts for landscape and portrait orientation. Currently we are in section 2 and we are about to check out the second video of this section. So in this video, we will create layouts for both portrait and landscape orientation. So currently our application appears to be like this. It has some background color with a text that says Hello Portrait, and then we have a button on click of which we will show a toast message. To satisfy our needs, I will create the separate layout for the landscape orientation, where our text view will say Hello Landscape and the button will display a toast message as per the orientation. And also I will change the background color of my layout. Well, we can do it by using the configuration qualifiers, which we saw in the previous section, remember? So we will have a default layout folder, which will be used for both portrait and landscape orientation. Then we will create a layout land folder that will only be used for landscape orientation. Now when we create the layout land folder, then our default layout folder will be used automatically for the portrait orientation. But in special case for some special layouts, if you want some customization for the portrait orientation as well, then you can create layout port folder as well, which will be used only for the portrait orientation. In most of the case, these two folders of layout and layout land will satisfy our needs. So we don't have to create layout port folder every time. So within our demo application, which we created in the previous video, here this is my layout. Now on click of this button, I want to display a toast message. So within my main activity, I will use my button, set the on click listener, and then write a toast message. We are in portrait mode. Perfect. Run the application. We are in portrait mode. Let us now change the screen orientation to landscape. Click on the same button. It says we are in portrait mode, but I want to customize my layout as per my need. So for that, what I will do, I will go to my activity main.xml, and there within the design tab, if you notice on the top, we have this orientation for preview icon. There you will find create the landscape variation for this layout. If you select it, then it is simply going to create a new file of activity main.xml for the landscape orientation, which you can find within the resource layout folder. So here within the activity main, it shows it has two variations, one for the default one and another just for the landscape orientation. Fine. Now here we can customize our layout. Just go to the text tab and replace the code from the code snippet 2.xml. Just copy all of these code from this file and then paste it here. Go to the design tab and there our layout has now changed. Now in these two layouts you will find a lot of variation, but there are similarities as well. For example, the name of the files are same, activity main.xml. And also if you notice, the ID of these two views such as text view and button, which you can find here, are also same, such as txv welcome and also button show toast. These two matches with the layout of landscape variation, which you can compare here as well. So always remember, whenever you create any variation for the same layout, make sure the ID should always remain same. Otherwise, your application might crash in the runtime, stating that the resources were not found in that orientation. Once you are sure the IDs are matched, then you can modify the properties of the views as per your requirement. You can change the font size, font style, and even you can change the text of the button. It is totally up to your wish. Let us run the application. Rotate the screen. And there we go. We are now getting a separate layout in the landscape. Now in this slide I showed you that we have to create a separate folder of layout land, but within our application, if you notice, we don't have any such folder. We just have a one folder of layout. Now this is simply because currently we are working under the Android view. So if you change the view to project view, then you will find all the files and folders, for example app, source, main, then resource, layout and layout land folder. Well, you will get all the files and folders as it is present on your disk. So if you expand it, you will find activity main and also activity main.xml. Now earlier I showed you the shortcut to create the landscape or portrait variation like this. But now you can also create this folder manually. For that you have to go to resource, create the new Android resource directory. From there, select the resource type as layout. And now since we have to add the qualifier, so from the available qualifier, select the orientation qualifier. Click on this button, select landscape. Now here you will find the folder name as layout land. Click on OK. Once you do it, you will find this folder here. So within this folder, you can copy this activity main.xml and paste it here. Once you paste it, then you can modify your layout as per your requirement, like we did earlier. So just now you saw the second way of creating the layout land folder manually and customize your layout. Pretty simple, isn't it? Now the question arises, how in the runtime we are getting the two separate layouts in both the orientation? So for that, let us go to our main activity.kt file. There, if you notice, we have r.layout.activitymain.xml. Now as we all know, when we rotate the screen, our activity gets destroyed and recreated in the new orientation. So in that case, suppose we launch the application in the portrait mode. So in the portrait mode, this statement will simply draw the layout from the default available layout folder. Now when we rotate the screen, so in that case, this statement will simply load the layout from layout land folder. As simple as that, isn't it? Now how about if you click on this button and you get a message, we are in portrait mode. So how about we customize this message as well as per the screen orientation. So within your Kotlin file, you just have to write the if else conditional statement. If getResources.getConfiguration.orientation is equal to portrait orientation, then in that case, simply execute this toast statement. Else, we are in landscape mode, so simply execute this toast statement that hey, we are in landscape mode. Once you are done, run your application, change the orientation, click on show message, and there we go, we are in landscape mode. Pretty simple, isn't it? Now similar to layouts, you can also customize your resources for drawable and also the values folder. So for that, you have to create the separate folder such as drawable port, drawable land, and even values land or values port. And accordingly, you can place your images or string files. So that was all for this video. In the next video, we will see what are SW, W, and H configuration qualifiers. See you there.